Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some of you know Bridget Bardot. Well, now it's time for the Cognac Show. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh, ooh. I'm your bubbly blonde, fabulously dressed to impress.
Sorry to bother you. I'm Matt King.
Yeah, I've come to pick up my daughter, Alexandra.
Alex?
Dad? What's up, Dad? What's happening?
You need to come home and see your mom. I'm the backup parent, the understudy. I thought you were supposed to be getting your act together.
I've been doing really well, actually. Nobody ever seems to notice that.
And with Elizabeth, my wife, in the hospital, my daughter's attesting me.
Look who's here.
Get out of my underwear, you freak.
Oh, okay.
Don't
back inside now.
Real good job you're doing.
We have to go through this thing together, you and Scotty and me.
Dad, this is Sid. He's going to be with me. I'll be a lot more civil with him around.
Sup, bro?
Don't ever do that to me again. I have to go around and tell people what's happening, family and a few close friends.
I don't want to talk about Mom with anyone.
Look, whatever you two fought about, you have to drop it. Grow up.
You really don't have a clue, do you? Dad, Mom was cheating on you.
Who is he? I'd like to know who the guy is that my wife was seeing.
What you've been going through, that's a tough deal.
I'm just trying to keep my head above water.
I'm gonna hit you.
How often do old people just haul off and cold cock you like that?
Gorgeous. Tell my audience, introduce yourself to the camera.
Hi, I'm Shailene Woodle. I'm an actor. I was in the film The Descendants.
And you look gorgeous. Tell my audience what you're wearing. This is a gorgeous dress. Who's the designer?
It's a designer. Well, Zach Posen does this small line called Z-Spoke. So, Z-Spoke.
Tell my audience about this character that you portray in the film.
I play a 17-year-old who's going through her angsty period in life, who thinks the world is out to get her, and it was fun. I got to be messy and raw and say bad words and do bad things.
And you love playing the part, right? What role would you like to play? Do you have a role that you have in mind that you'd like to play later on down the road?
No, you know, I really don't have any roles that in my mind that I would like to play. I generally just like to read a script and see whatever fuels my soul, whatever I'm passionate about.
That's a true actress, darling. You chose the right answer to tell me. Tell my audience, if we want to find out more information about this film, where can we go on the internet?
If you want to find more information about the film, I guess you could go to Fox Searchlight's website. It's a Fox Searchlight film. It premieres November 18th.
And what about you? Where can we go to find out more information about you as an actress?
To find about more information about me as an actor? I don't know.
Do you have a website?
I don't have a website. I don't have a
Twitter. No Facebook?
No Facebook.
You
no
need
Facebook.
That, darling. The fans want to have, they want to tweet with you. They want to Facebook with you.
Yeah, but you know, my prior, I like to act because of the art of it, and I honestly hate computers.
We do a lot of work in the Hamptons, a lot of celebrity events. We supply butlers, bartenders, servers, waiters, captains, cooks, grillers.
I love it.
Whatever you need. PlatterServiceInc.com or call 631-589-6999.
Aren't you gorgeous? Aren't you gorgeous? Say, come on, let's talk about the thing. Look at you. Look at you. We all know who you are, but introduce yourself to the camera, doll.
Hi.
Introduce yourself.
Dina Lohan, I'm here supporting the film festival. We've seen some amazing movies already. But
any film in particular that you've seen so far that you really, really enjoy?
It goes out to anything with domestic violence or, you know, a positive message. So I'm supporting the young guys that are making films like that.
What about you? Am I going to see you in another reality show?
God willing, no.
Ihr kennt Kaspar Friedmann, den Regisseur am Schauspielhaus. Er inszeniert wieder und er macht Camille und er will alle Rollen mit Studenten besetzen.
Josephine, du spielst Camille.
Camille geht bis zum Äußersten. Die vögelt sich fast zu Tode, die schneidet sich die Arme auf. Und du? Bist du kaputt? Machst du Männer an?
Ich soll also alles durchmachen, was Camille durchmacht? Ich lass mich vergewaltigen und ritz mir die Haut auf?
Ritzen ist ein bisschen harmlos gedacht.
Wir sind ja nicht auf der Schule.
Ich bin Camille.
Joachim.
Merken Sie sich meinen Namen?
Ganz allein?
Sex ist für mich wie Kuchen essen. Ich esse und esse und kann nicht genug davon bekommen.
Leute, ich brauche Energie. Ich brauche Spannung. Ihr müsst aufwachen.
Camille? Camille!
Ich will nicht mehr.
Bleib doch hier.
Du wirst dann?
Ja, ich werde dich quälen. Du wirst dich quälen. Klasse!
Du bist ein Sadist.
Ja, das hat nichts mit Theater zu tun. Das ist Psychokacke.
Warum hast du mich besetzt? Weil du denkst, dass ich einen Schaden habe?
Nimm jetzt alle durch!
Das bist doch nicht du. Das ist nur die Rolle.
Introduce yourself to the camera.
Yeah, I'm Stine Fischer Christensen. I'm an actress from Denmark.
Beautiful outfit. I love your hat. Who's it designed by?
It's designed by a Danish designer called Stine Goya, who also did my pants.
Gorgeous. Tell us about the movie that you're in.
It's a movie I did in Germany. It's my first German-speaking role. It's about an actress. It's a coming of age. For this girl.
The hat, by the way, reminds me of Marlene Dietrich.
Oh, thank you.
She was German.
Yes. Yeah. I'm not, but I pretend to be.
Well, you do a good job, darling. You're doing a very good job.
Thank you, and you look beautiful.
Thank you. So tell my audience, where can we go to find out more information about this movie? Does it have a website?
I don't know, but it's in the competition. It's one of the five. So,
tell my audience the name again.
The film, Cracks in the Shell.
Cracks in the Shell.
Yes.
Interesting. What's it about?
It's about an actress who is portraying a role, and it's, her struggle with that and her personal life. interfering with her work.
Sounds like
it's very interesting.
Sounds very interesting. We'll be back, darlings. More interviews coming up.
Puerto Rico. I came down here looking for a story.
It's called journalism.
Your resume, huh? Don't look so anxious. I wouldn't have paid for your hotel if I hadn't already hired you.
But I found the strangest paradise on earth.
Hey, you made it.
But you said you had a TV.
The guy across the alley has a TV. I have binoculars.
It's where your secrets come to dance.
Don't notice the wig. Whoa.
And the voodoo works its magic. And if the drinking doesn't get you into trouble...
How does anybody drink 161 miniatures?
Are they not complimentary?
The women definitely will.
I thought maybe you were a mermaid.
I'm from Connecticut.
Stay away from her. She's Sanderson's fiancé.
She's sunbathed in the nude. Take it like two maracas. She's a sweet little beauty. I was looking at his boat.
We've all been down on her. It's a wonderful experience.
Now, all this might sound like some crazed hallucination, but it's all true. I think.
This place is a sea of money, Paul. And there's people like me who know how to get it out.
Isn't that kind of thing illegal?
It's an inappropriate comment.
We've nailed this bastard to his own front door.
I got a story for you. I'm going after him.
Are you out of your mind?
I bet you scream before I do.
No such thing as 470 proof alcohol.
What we do is private.
Front seat's gone.
I've got a brilliant idea.
Try and look normal.
And I played Bob Saller, who's like Johnny's best friend in the film. 1960 Puerto Rico, a lot of rum. And
a lot of cocktails,
oh
huh?
Oh my God, yes, yeah.
That was an era that people drank and smoked and nobody cared.
And which was great because now all the time in the films, and most of the time in the films, you can't even have a cigarette, but we smoked and drank and it was great.
So tell my audience about this film.
Well, it's about Hunter Thompson. It was a novel by Hunter Thompson that Johnny found with Hunter toward, they actually found it under his bed. He had never published it. And Johnny said, what's this? And they sat down and they read it. And he said, Hunter, we got to do this. And sure enough, they put it into works. And then Johnny found Bruce Robinson, who is a tremendous novelist and writer and director. And he kind of pulled him out of retirement a little bit and said, you have to adapt this and you have to direct it. And Bruce did, and it turned out wonderful.
Terrific. Yeah. Tell my audience, if we want to find out more information about this film, Where can we go on the internet? Does it have a website?
Yeah, you can go to Rum Diary. Yeah, just look up the Rum Diary. You Google it, and it's all going to come up. It opens October 28th.
In theaters,
October 28th, yeah. And there was a premiere in L.A., and this is the East Coast premiere for here.
World premiere, Joe.
At the Hamptons Film Festival, that's right.
That's right. What about you? If we want to find out more information about you as an actor, do you have a website, a Facebook, anything?
No, I don't do
Facebook?
I get too many people calling up and saying, hey, we had chemistry class together, so I don't do Facebook, you know. But the truth is, you just go online and you look up Michael Rispoli and it'll pop up.
Thank you, Michael.
Thank you. Thank you. All right.
And we'll be back in a moment, darlings, with more interviews right here at the Hamptons International Film Festival. Keep on.
Let's see, dressed to impress. One of a kind girl.
This has been a Crybaby Productions, darlings.